What's going on, guys? It's Bromley. We're at Empire Barbell, and today we're going to go over some tips for you novice strength athletes out there. Now, before I get into the list of do and do nots, first we need to cover exactly what a novice is. What makes you guys different from intermediate and advanced athletes, and how does that determine ultimately where you're going to spend your attention when it comes to putting a training block together? So, really quickly, we've covered this before. I'm gonna just go down the brief synopsis of how the body works when it comes to strength development. We have our brain, which sends impulses through our nervous system to motor units and our muscles. Each muscle only has so many motor units, but at any given time, we can only use a small percentage of those motor units. That is a big factor in determining where our ceiling is. So with each of us, we have this hypothetical ceiling. The ceiling is kind of a imaginary representation of what our 100% would be. If we could somehow take the governor off of our bodies and just put out as much force as we could, you know, theoretically do if there was nothing inhibiting us, that's an idea of where our ceiling is, and how good we are at recruiting motor units is going to determine where our baseline is relative to that ceiling. Now, this is important for a couple of reasons. The big one is that determining where the ceiling is and how close we are to that ceiling at our baseline is going to be hugely important in understanding what our recovery is going to be like. And ultimately, whatever training program you put together, that's the number one thing you have to think of. How am I going to recover from this? Am I going to have way too much downtime, or am I actually going to overreach? Am I going to run myself ragged from doing this? So the one theme that more advanced lifters find as they get more developed down the road is that the better you get, the smarter you have to be. Novices have a very distinct superpower, and that is they can train recklessly, they can train often, they can even train, for all intents and purposes, incorrectly and still grow. As you get better and more specific, as your ceiling raises and as your baseline relative to that ceiling increases, you get closer to this hypothetical 100%, which means you're putting more and more strain on your body. So that is the main difference. I mean, if you take an elite athlete, right? You take an elite power lifter, you have somebody who has not only developed a very high ceiling by growing more muscle tissue over time, becoming more refined in their lift, getting thicker joints, but you get somebody whose baseline relative to their ceiling is very close, almost razor thin. So those people are the people that need to deload 4 weeks out from a meet, you know, to have their peak go well. Those are the people that might only deadlift heavy twice a month. Those are the people that can have very long periods of time in between their training because they need to, because for everything to recover so they put up a good showing at the next workout, that's how much time is required because they are revving on all cylinders. So we have kind of two ideas for how you develop. There's the broad traits that you develop, and this is your base. Most of your training should actually be developing your base, because the broader the base, the broader the foundation, the higher your ceiling goes. That's just the way it works. So you're talking about adding muscle to your frame, you're talking about strengthening joints and connective tissue, and you're talking about nervous system development as well, because any work you do with the barbell, any resistance training you do, is still gonna have some neurological benefit, and it's gonna help you recruit more motor units, it's gonna help you improve the communication between muscles. So you need to get all these things firing on all cylinders, and the more practice you have under the barbell, the better you're gonna get at that. It's one of the reasons high volume work is good. You get more touches, more practice to get this down. Strength specific stuff, I think of as a cherry on top. To be a fully realized strength athlete, yes, you absolutely need strength specific traits, but these are things that only come after you've built a sizable foundation. So strength specific stuff is gonna be largely neurological. It's gonna be mostly about your coordination, how efficient you are at recruiting motor units. The more motor units you can pull relative to your ceiling, and the faster you can pull them, that is gonna determine basically how much weight you lift that day. So you definitely wanna develop those strength-specific traits and close the gap. But it's important to know these improvements, they're only gonna be relative to your ceiling. So if you are training ultimately as strength-specific as possible, you're limiting your ability to raise that ceiling. It's mainly gonna be more about closing that gap. So we have a couple visual representations over here. The novice is gonna have a very low ceiling, and they're also going to be pretty separated. The low ceiling is because they're untrained. Joints aren't gonna be very strong. They're not gonna have a lot of muscle on their frame. They're not gonna have a very good endurance base. So they're not gonna be able to handle a lot of load to begin with. And because their nervous system is untrained, they're not even really close to what their true 100% capabilities are. As you get more advanced, you notice that the broad traits improve, which means the ceiling improves. So as you go from novice to intermediate, you're talking about accruing more muscle tissue. You're talking about having a better handle on technique. You're talking about your joints starting to thicken out. You're getting a little more resilient to the type of work that you need to do to get strong in the first place. And ultimately, when you think about the most advanced lifters, you think about people who have the highest ceiling you could have for your weight class. Now, on top of those broad traits, that wide foundation being set, you have, over time, more strength-specific development. So if you're routinely doing a lot of strength-specific work in the form of singles, doubles, and triples, then you are going to, over time, increase your nervous system efficiency, which means you're going to be able to pull a higher percentage of those motor units. You're going to be able to close the gap between your baseline and that ceiling. Every time you raise this ceiling, you are still imposing more demand on your body. It is not as hard on your body to have this low ceiling when it comes to delivering nutrients to muscle tissue, when it comes to filtering out waste product, when it comes to repairing the damage you do from a workout. This is not very stressful because at the end of the day, your heart, your lungs, your stomach and digestive tract, they don't change a lot. But when you go from 140 pounds to 340 pounds, those structures that don't move around a whole lot are being asked to do a hell of a lot more. So there's a lot more systemic stress. Now, as that baseline increases, as you get closer to your ceiling, as you become a more specific, more advanced athlete, now you're talking about just redlining it. It's not only that your ceiling went up, it's that now you're actually operating close to that ceiling. I mean, it's like having a race car just redlined the whole way, and that's what your training is. That means you're not gonna be able to do that as much. So there's a good and a bad to that. The bad part of being a novice is obviously you're not a very good athlete. The good news is, though, novices can typically train a little more recklessly and still progress. And the reason they get away with that for a long time is because the loads you're handling aren't going to be so devastating if you get out of position. You know, you're less likely to throw your back out with 135 as you are to throw your back out with 500 pounds. That's just the way it is. Now, that can also be a bad thing, though, because that can build bad habits. That can reinforce things that absolutely will screw you down the road. I myself went through those growing pains. Somewhere in the intermediate gap between novice and advanced, I had to realize that I couldn't do the same things because I would get strong, injured, and that cycle would repeat. I also couldn't do the same things because even when I wasn't getting injured, I wasn't getting any stronger because I was overreaching. So there was definitely a point where I had to realize that more is absolutely not better. So now that we have this breakdown of what actually makes novices different from everybody else, we're going to go down our list of approved methods for getting your ass out of the novice division as quickly as possible. These are the things you want to focus on so you can blow away your peers and end up in that intermediate advanced range as soon as you can, right? Sooner the better, while keeping yourself in one piece.